Well, good morning, everyone. Welcome back to the Outpost. I've got the rest of the insulation that I can actually put in preparation for going and getting a load of plywood to be able to put down for the flooring. I'm excited about getting the floor down because I'm actually going to need it when the little puppy gets here, or because he's just going to be running around everywhere. And since he's going to be, you know, so small, I'm going to have to keep an eye on him. So having the floor down in there will help a great deal while I'm putting all the angle iron pieces on the upper beams and supports and preparing that for building the exterior walls. So hope you guys sit back, stay tuned, and enjoy the video. Thank you. Well, I stopped to take a little bit of a break. Jennifer's on her way up here. She called me and said she was going to bring me a little bite to eat. So I was reading a few comments, and some of them are like, why don't I stand down between the floor joists to staple that stuff up? Well, if I did that, I would have to get down in there and back out every time. And so that's a lot of times in and out. And it's a whole lot easier for me to just bend over and staple it. You know, I don't tell this to everybody, but I did teach martial arts for 28 years, and it's good to stretch, you know. You may have seen me do it on camera, but sometimes I bend over and I don't bend my legs on purpose so that I stretch out my hamstrings. That way I maintain, you know, my range of mobility. But anyway, yeah, I've got two sections left, which is the center section and then this back section, and that insulation is done. So the next thing to do would be to get some plywood and start putting the flooring down. But anyway, I'm going to get a drink of water and get back at it. Sounds like her.
I'm worried. Hi, fellow YouTube friends. I brought a Taco Bell, minus the cheese. What's up, peeps? The gesture's back. Kidding. It was actually gonna be for a few minutes, but now it's gonna be like a split second. Something happened to my car on the way here, and I need to go figure out what's going on with it. Anyway, I guess you could call me freshly frazzled. But I did bring Dad Taco Bell, and been busy commenting all day on your all's comments, and I hope you know that I actually look forward to seeing you all comment. And some of you all commented for the very first time. Hang on just a second. Some of you all commented today on today's video for the very first time, and I want to say welcome. And now we can like put a face with the name, so to speak. Like as you as a subscriber, follower, friend.
I have had some people want to know why I didn't use rock wool because of the cost. It's more expensive than this, and I didn't really feel like I needed rock wool because we are here in the South and it doesn't get that cold. I really didn't see the need in spending the money for the rock wool when this R19 and that radiant barrier, when I get that installed, I think it's going to be really more than sufficient. But yeah, good comments, a lot of good comments. We want.
I didn't want five. I wanted the taco.
Oh, you want a taco?
No, I'm just kidding. It's okay. It just looked kind of good. But
hey,
yes,
you know what?
What?
It is.
I bet. We're gonna go live on this Saturday, okay, guys? 7 p.m. Eastern time.
That'll be tomorrow.
Yeah. Yeah, tomorrow. And we hope to see you there. We really do. It's, you know, we can comment so much, but I feel like when we're actually able to interact on the lives, that it just, I don't know, brings it together so much more, and I feel so much closer to you all. And if you can't tell, I'm kind of sort of a people person, if I like you so.
By the way, if you haven't checked out the new channel, Outpost Review,
woo woo!
Go check that out. And if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe, because it does help us to get the channel out there to other people that may like something like that, may benefit from it in some way, maybe a little trip or tip that I've learned over the years. Now, I'm not anybody to teach on how to build anything, that's for sure. And this is not a how-to channel, because there's plenty of YouTube channels that have tutorials on how to do things, but this is just the way we're doing things here on this homestead. Down in the description area, there's a link to the channel, or you could actually use the little hourglass on YouTube and search Outpost Review. And when that comes up, there will be several thumbnails because of the new movie Outpost. There will be reviews in there of that as well, but just keep scrolling and you should be able to find it. Yeah, if you haven't checked it out, go check it out. Maybe something that you like.
Okie dokie. Well, I think I'm going to head out of here. I need to go see what's wrong with my car. Hopefully it's nothing.
I think it's the battery cables.
Yeah, because I was just driving it and all of a sudden all the things went whoop whoop. And it kind of like turned off-ish, but wasn't off. I don't know. It was really odd.
Well, folks, I'm going to eat this up and get back at it. I think I can finish those two sections up before the sun hits the ridge over there. So anyway, thanks for bringing me that. Call me and let me know what's up with the car.
I will. Good to see you all. Take care. You'll actually be seeing me on the next video that goes out, so that'll be, what, Mondays? Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right, guys. I'm going to hit the road and figure out what's going on. I will catch you later. Be safe. Take care. Hi.
Call me. Let me know what's up.
Okay.
That was the last full piece. I'm down to all these cut pieces now. I lacked 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 full pieces, but the way I figured it, I had plenty if I didn't have to cut them. So yeah, if I didn't have that blocking in the middle right there, they would have came out just right. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take the pieces and shove them fairly tight together and finish this all out, but I think I'll wait till tomorrow to work on that because it is getting late. Sun's just about to go over the ridge. Oh, by the way, Jennifer called and said that it was just the corroded terminals on her battery. I had taken some Coke and poured around it to kind of dissolve some of the corrosion, and then she stopped by there in town and got it taken care of. I'm going to work on this tomorrow.
The only time that I can blow smoke. No. Anyway, blame it on the daughter. He's having to make French toast and bacon for me because I'm hungry. Anyway, we are about to go and get the plywood. Anyway, we hope you had a wonderful Thanksgiving holiday and that you spent it hopefully with family and friends. I know some of you may not be doing that this year because of the whole COVID deal. But either way, we hope you enjoyed your holiday, and we will catch up with you real soon. Oh.
All right. Lord, we thank you for this food. We ask that you bless it to the nourishment of our bodies. We want to thank you for all of your blessings that you have given to us and to this channel. We ask that you bless everyone that's watching, Lord. We ask that you forgive us of our shortcomings. We'll give you all the glory, honor, and the praise in Christ's name. Amen.
Amen.
All right. French toast, a little bit of change, but got to have the bacon or the ham or the sausage. You know, I never was a cereal eater. I
had to be fed.
I just find that after I eat it, I'm still hungry again. So, a lot of times I'll have fruit, but
I
tell you what, there's nothing I would rather have than bacon and eggs. I could eat that every morning. Anyway, we're going to be heading to the lumber yard here shortly. I have just about got all the insulation in, but since Jennifer's off, I was going to take her with me ride back out, get a load of tongue and groove OSB, 3/4 inch for the flooring. Anyway, guys, thanks for stopping by and hanging out with us. We're going to get this ate up, and then we're going to get on the road and go get the subflooring, bring it out here, and then I'll get ready and finish that insulation. Well, you can see that we made it back with 32 pieces of this 3/4 inch OSB tongue and groove. That's what I'm going to put down in there. Jennifer seems to think that she's going to help me unload all that. She's feeling frisky. Anyway, I guess it was a good thing that I made that French toast and bacon, because by the time she moves, all this is going to be burned off. Anyway, we're going to unhook it from the truck, hook the tractor up, and I'm going to see if I can get it backed up here as close as possible, and we're going to try to unload that and get it in here in the cabin. So that's what we're getting ready to do.
Let's do this.
Thank you.
Too much.
There you go. You need to scoot yours more over to this side. You're coming off this.
How many's over there?
Five.
Okay.
So you want to carry
this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah.
And then we'll just put these and then we're...
Right there and we're done.
We're done and done.
Oh, God. We could stick a fork in it. Did you do the last piece by yourself?
Nope.
You want to drive it in there?
Sure. Yeah, come in sideways. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Can you believe that we've got them unloaded? Jennifer, she crushed it.
Listen, dynamite comes in small packages. I hide the guns very well.
But I figured I needed 32 pieces. So we've got 11, 11, and 10. Because I'm gonna start on that back corner and build my way this way. So that is ready to rock and roll. I got just a few pieces of insulation to put down. You know, the stove, I'm going to have to get a stove here real soon to put in over there. So when I get the floor down, I can actually put my chimney in, my flue, and get the stove set up where I can work in here during the wintertime.
What side of the turkey has most feathers?
Just tell us.
The outside. Yeah, the outside of the turkey. Duh.
Okay. All right. We've got a few things to do left, kind of clean up. I'm going to clean up inside the bunks of the sawmill and get some of that sawdust out. because I'm going to start milling. Once those logs come down here for the sill plates, top and bottom, I'm going to be doing a lot of milling. And you know, folks, I hope that doesn't get monotonous to you, but that's just part of a everyday life up here at the outpost. When I have to go do something, I've got to mill something. I try not to film too much of it, but I have a surprise for the general manager, the superintendent,
court jester,
and the comic relief for the outpost. So excuse me just a second and I'll run and get it.
Should I be scared? Should I be excited? I think I'll be both. You never know what he's got up his sleeve. He's digging in his truck. That's not a good sign, is it? There's a bag, it's rattling. Something's in a bag.
This is an outpost holiday gift for all of the stuff that you do up here. It is the outpost bear dressed up holiday style.
How cute. Maybe I can have my friend embroider Smo 2020.
It's already got 2020 on it.
Oh, well then I'll just have her add Smo or something.
Put a red SMO on the bottom of it.
Yeah, because she's got an embroidery machine. Well, thank you.
Okay.
Look how cute, y'all.
Yeah, they didn't have a turkey this 2020, so I would have got her a Thanksgiving turkey. But
oh, this is cute. Bentley will like it.
Bentley will?
Yeah. Why did the farmer separate the chicken and the turkey?
I have a feeling you're going to tell us.
Yep. He suspected foul play.
So, am I going to have to build a chicken house and a turkey house?
Sure, for all the gobblers.
Okay, I think it's time to go clean up sawdust.
Woo.
Okay. So anyway, Jennifer, she's got a small party that she's going to have to go attend, so she's going to head out and hope the little SMO bear keeps you and Bentley all cuddly at night.
Oh, yes. He is cute.
You think Bentley can actually pick it up?
I don't know. I'll have to take a video and see.
All right. Anyway. So we're going to say goodbye, guys. Appreciate you stopping by and hanging out with us. I know that this was kind of a short and different video, but I had to get the supplies up here to be able to put down the floor. So anyway, we appreciate you guys and all the support that you give us. Thank you so much. We want to wish you a great afternoon. Take care, and we look forward to seeing you back up here at the Outpost again next time.
Be blessed.